With the release of their debut album in 2014, Beat & Berg introduced a unique sound that took over the pop genre, exploring Kwaito, house and Baganga. They have broken radio chart records and won numerous awards as a result, including a sweep of SAMA Awards. They're back this year with the brand new album, 12 Views of Beat & Berg, and we get to hear it live in the loft later on.
My head's in the way, my head's in the way, my head's in the way of my heart. Head's in the way, my head's in the way, my head's in the way of my heart. Chelsea Blackmore, I don't wanna play this game. Chelsea Blackmore, I don't wanna call you name.
Gentlemen, please welcome onto the loft, Beat & Berg. Welcome back. Lovely to have you back with us.
Thanks for having us. Yeah. Thank you so much.
What immediately strikes me about you is you have a very different real-life appearance and your image to your on-stage. Would you say
this
that?
This is part of the on-stage image as well.
Is this part of the on-stage?
Yeah, this is not real life yet.
Well, I just saw in the music, I guess that's
right.
The music video.
Yeah, yeah, that was
you
a particular...
You just look proper Capetonian, I guess.
What, now or in the
yeah,
video?
Yeah, right now.
Oh, okay. Okay. Well, that's cool.
I'm feeling it. I'm here for it. Yeah. I'm here for it. Yeah. Yeah. So your first album did extraordinarily well. Mm. Did you expect that?
Basically no.
I don't think you could expect something like that. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, we hoped it would do well, but we had no idea.
Yeah, and I'm sure it was a whirlwind, but what are some of the challenges that came with it happening so quickly and so furiously?
I was still working, for example. Like, I was in an office and then I'd be catching emails.
What were you doing?
I was a web developer, building websites and stuff. Uh-huh. And then I'd be getting emails like, yo, your song just hit number one on like a certain radio station. I'd be like, oh wait, I gotta finish this thing I'm doing. And then the next 8 hours of work, and then every day, you know what I mean, it was just getting out of control. Mm. It was crazy.
Yeah. And any other challenges you experienced? The fame. What did the fame feel like?
That was intense. I mean, it's still like a learning.
Keeping in touch with like what really
matters.
Means to you. That's I guess the challenge.
Yeah.
Just making sure that you're doing it for the not necessarily for the same reason you started, but for a reason that is still true to you, and not just because you're doing it.
Yeah.
And I think we've been like finding our way with that. Yeah.
And how do you find the balance between making sure that you're not just releasing albums for the sake of having to release another album, but that you feel like it's time and that you're ready, but also pushing yourself at the same time?
I think we always want to release albums for the sake of just music. Like, I guess it took us a long time to do this last one, but it's not because we don't want to release a lot of albums, I guess. I don't know.
I think it's taken the period of time because we were dealing with kind of the success of the last album and processing what that meant to us and what is important to us. And you know, that's musically, personally, everything, you know?
Yeah.
So I think it's been sort of a period of figuring a lot of things out.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah.
Yeah.
So your new offering is called 12 Views of Beat & Berg. There's an interesting story behind it. It's very philosophical. Tell me about it.
Maybe. I guess... I don't know if it's hard to explain these things. I guess it's just that there are more than 12 songs on it. The initial idea was that there'd be 12 songs. I thought it'd be kind of funny in the end that there were more songs than the views, because you know the 12 views corresponded to the songs. I'm not very good at talking about what it means.
Well, there's a whole mountain. There's a whole table mountain.
There's a mountain.
Mount Beat & Berg.
Yeah, I mean, Berg obviously means mountain.
But there's
mountain.
Also this angle, which I explained to a friend the other day, which is that there's a play on words, which is that there are our views, but there are also views of us. It's like perspectives on the band.
That's one
but
of
it's
the
also
things.
These are our perspectives, if you know what I mean.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like how we get to express something and also be read as certain types of people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which is nice. It's kind of subtle.
It is. Yeah. What can we expect from this album?
I think a lot of new sounds. I think it's not necessarily what everyone's going to be expecting, but I think if you give it the time and the energy and the... I think you already enjoy it.
Jeez, guys. I can't stop you from talking. I can't stop you from talking today. And any exciting collaborations that you hooked up with?
Well, you know, Matt wrote a song with Trezor, Aphrodite.
That's the only one on the album.
Yeah.
But it's a cool one.
Incredible song.
Such a great song.
Yeah, I think you guys do have a knack for choosing the right kind of collaborations.
Yeah, that's definitely really important.
You guys are going to perform She's Not Like That shortly. What's it about?
You're going to make me not talk again. I don't really know.
I was thinking about that just now.
I was trying to think about what it's about when I was looking out the window now. I don't know, really. I don't know. I'll have to think about that.
Okay, awesome. Well, I'm glad you're going to sing it to us, at least.
Yeah.
It's so great to have you back in the loft, and we look forward to your performance.
Cool. Thanks very much.
Cool.